We're group 9, and we're going to be testing the efficiency of a Francis turbine under various conditions. The Francis turbine is the most commonly used water turbine in the world. It's designed so that it can use the high pressure from water and convert it into electrical energy. The way that works is that the energy from the water is used to spin blades within the turbine, which then sets off a generator which spins to create to transfer the kinetic energy to electrical. However, the experiment itself is not 100% efficient. There is a loss of energy within the process due to numerous factors. These factors may include friction, which is very hard to change. So the way we're going to try to optimize the efficiency is by changing the viscosity of the liquid used. The viscosity of the water changes with temperature, so we're going to increase and decrease the temperature, and also adding salt to the water will change the viscosity, so that's what we're going to do in the experiment. Our experiment has many real-life applications. For example, if the change in temperature of the water has an impact on the power, we can consider the place of installation. For example, if warmer water is better for efficiency, we can install it in a warmer environment, like a warmer country, for example. Also, if the salt appears to produce a better efficiency, then we might consider using ocean water rather than river water, or vice versa.
Checking how different conditions affect the efficiency of the Francis turbine, we have simulated 4 different environments, which we will then compare to see which gives the best result. We will reduce the temperature of the water to approximately 15 degrees Celsius, and also increase the temperature to approximately 55 degrees. We also will run the experiment at room temperature, which is approximately 22 degrees Celsius. We will simulate seawater at the same temperature by adding 3.5 kilograms of salt to a 100 liter water.
We believe that increasing the temperature will decrease the viscosity of the water, resulting in a higher pressure drain, which in theory should increase the efficiency of the
turbine. Here we can find the pump control. And here we could check the values of the volume flow rate as the water flows through the pipe. This is the guide vane adjust control. It's used to open and close the blades. Here we can find the heater. It's to heat up the water. And this one is the thermometer to check up the temperature. Here we're going to use the stroboscope to check how fast is the turbine spinning.
By finding out the mechanical power, we have 2 pi times rotational speed times torque over 60. We can find out torque by multiplying radius by the force difference. Then we can have the hydraulic power by timesing the volume flow rate by pressure over 1,000. And this is how we reach to the hydraulic efficiency by putting the mechanical power over the hydraulic power and times it by 100. So after calculating all the efficiencies, we've plotted this graph from most viscous to least viscous. The different colors shows the different weights for the right balance.
In regards to the hypothesis, the changes we've made affect the viscosity of the turbine, which affect the efficiency. Increase in temperature decreased the viscosity, which increased the pressure drop. However, we didn't take into consideration the viscosity
results. At 55 degrees, the pressure drag is high and the viscosity drag is low, giving a low efficiency. And at salted water, the pressure drag is low and the viscosity drag is high, giving also low efficiency. In order to optimize the efficiency of the turbine, both drags should be compromised. Depending on the turbine, one or the other drag should have more impact on the turbine. As you can see from our results, at 15 degrees, the efficiency is higher, meaning for this specific turbine, the viscous drag has more effect on the efficiency.
If you use a turbine in a hot country where the temperatures are rather warm, the turbine should be designed in order for the pressure drag to have more effect on the efficiency of the turbine. It's that simple.